from a goat simulator to a dating game featuring pigeons? Here are some of the weirdest games ever made. Number 11, Goat Simulator. Have you ever dreamt of being a goat? If yes, the Goat Simulator is the game that will fulfill this dream. The storyline revolves around a goat in a suburban setting. You have to cause as much damage as possible by bashing things, bouncing off trampolines, and performing backflips while ramming a bucket through a window, among other stunts. The points you earn by wrecking stuff allows you to become the Alpha Goat. This game is so bizarre that the developers called it broken and stupid. They further warn you that you're better off not expecting anything from the game at all. And your $10 would be well spent if you bought a hula hoop or a pile of bricks or just a real life goat. Coffee Stain Studios meant to release the game as a joke, never intending to make it a full title. But when footage of the game debuted on YouTube, it gathered more than a million hits in 2 days. The positive reviews convinced the studio to make it a full title and released it to stream in 2014. If you're bored off your rockers and you can't seem to figure out how to spend some free time, this might be something for you. Number 10, Icarus Proud Bottom in the Curse of the Chocolate Fountain. Do you remember the Greek mythology of Icarus? He was the son of a master craftsman, Daedalus, who hatched a plan to escape from Crete by fashioning a pair of wings for him and his son. He instructed Icarus not to soar too close to the ground or too high because the sun would melt the wax holding the feathers. Icarus ignored his father and chose to fly too high. The wax melted and he fell to his death. In this game, forget this myth. It features Proud Bottom, who never stops pooping. In fact, his defecation propels him to supersonic speeds. He flies around the world and to outer space. During his flights, he's joined by an owl that transforms into Katana, which is a Japanese sword. With the weapon, he can defend himself against creatures such as birds, neo-Nazis, a helicopter piloted by Barack Obama, asteroids, and other obstacles. Number 9. Mr. Mosquito. If you thought a goat was weird, try becoming a lone mosquito in Mr. Mosquito, a strange third-person flying game which takes place during the hot and humid days of summer when critters are aplenty. As a mosquito, you patrol the Yamada household in Japan. It's headed by Mr. Kenichi Yamada, a 46-year-old man who loves watching TV dressed in his favorite tracksuit. He is married to Kaneo, who is also 46 years old and loves photography. Finally, there is the 17-year-old Reina, who is a sophomore in high school and loves listening to jazz. The aim of Mr. Mosquito is to suck enough blood from the Yamada household, which will help him survive the winter. During the gameplay, each person is doing some activity like sleeping or taking a shower. You have to sneak up on the family members, land on an exposed body part, puncture the person's skin, and suck blood to fill the mosquito's blood bank. Sounds lovely, doesn't it? The chances of being spotted are high, and this leads to a battle of man against the insect. You might mess up if you enter the human's field of vision or suck blood too quickly. Anyway, it sounds like lots of fun. Number 8. Semen. Semen is a simulation game released by Dreamcast on July 29th, 1999. You play as a new pet owner responsible for semen species, which is a fish with a human face. The man fish doesn't come with any instructions, so you have to figure out everything by yourself, such as how to nourish this horrific monstrosity. You have to keep the tank oxygenated and heated to keep the semen happy and breathing. In a separate tank, the player must raise and care for larvae, the primary food for a semen. These larvae feed on green leaves from a plant growing in the same tank. They later morph into moss, which lay eggs that hatch into larvae. There are occasional instructions given by the narrator, Leonard Nimoy, that American actor who played Spock in the Star Trek franchise. Number 7. Shaq Fu. In 1994, Shaquille O'Neal was an upcoming basketball star. He was rescuing the ailing Orlando Magic franchise, and fans throughout the country couldn't have enough of him. So he released a rap album called Shaq Fu. Then, he lent his name to Delphine Software International, who created Shaq Fu, a 2D fighting game. The weirdness begins with the hard-to-swallow storyline. Shaq enters a dojo used for martial arts en route to a charity basketball game in Tokyo. He meets and speaks to a martial arts master, Lyotsu. He learns that he has to travel to another dimension to save a boy from an evil mummy. Crappia Games Wikia outlines 10 things which made the game suck. Some include the boring sound effects, terrible controls, product placement of Pepsi, and the inconceivable concept. The game has inspired a movement called the Shaq Fu Liberation Front, whose mission is to buy all copies of the game and destroy them from existence. Shaquille hopes to redeem himself from the eyes of gamers by releasing an updated Shaq Fu sequel called Legend Reborn. The trailer was released on the PlayStation official YouTube page in Feb 2018. Everything has improved, though there is still an endorsement of Icy Hot, a pain management cream, in the game. The big lesson here is, not all things change. Number 6. LSD Dream Emulator. LSD is one of the weirdest games of all time, released on October 22, 1998 by Ashmeek Ace Entertainment. It was created by Osomu Sato and based on the Dream Journal, which an employee of the studio, Hiroko Nishikawa, kept for 10 years. There are no goals and no opponents in this game. You walk around in a computer-generated environment. You can run into walls and bump into things. Eyes may pop from a wall, you might see elephants running into a pit, or jump off cliffs. The insanity keeps growing the more you play the game. Textures become more messed up, and the fear keeps rising. Keep in mind that all the things you see were real dreams of Hiroko Nishikawa. It has since garnered somewhat of a cult following in Japan, and there is a fan remake coming out in the future. Number 5. Revenge of the Sunfish. The popularity of the Revenge of the Sunfish game is inconceivable. Created by Jacob Bugzinski before his last year, 12 Exams, it's been called tasteless, incoherent, and disturbing. In case you were wondering, he passed his exams and he's currently working on the sequel, Revenge of the Sunfish 2. In the gameplay, the formidable sunfish are the antagonists who want to enslave humankind. Jacob's inspiration to use sunfish came during a school trip to a local aquarium. It has horrible MS Paint graphics, and there is no decent animation. The rules are weird too. Players can never be stuck at any level. If the player dies several times on one stage, they are sent back to later levels. Jacob claims that this will keep the game from becoming boring. If you're looking for something made so badly that is fascinating, all you have to do is visit its website. Number 4. Keyboard Sports – Saving QWERTY. Saving QWERTY is a delightful game developed by Triband and published by Humble. Triband loves keyboards so much that they made a game which makes you use and love your keyboard. Soon, it'll be replaced by voice recognizing and touch-based input devices. In the game, you play as a young apprentice to Master QWERTY, who will guide you on various adventures on the quest to find your inner key. Currently, you have about 102 keys on your keyboard, and Key Sports helps you to use and appreciate each one. That makes it unique and lots of fun. Furthermore, the environments are humorous and vibrant. Number 3. Japan World Cup 3. Japan seems to have a flair for producing weird games. This game has nothing to do with soccer, though it borrows from horse racing. The game is set on a well-manicured race course. Players bet on a series of horse races where jockeys race weird beasts. Some include a walrus, a wooden Trojan horse, a horse that runs on its hind legs, a yeti, and a long barrel with 6 human legs poking out, which poses as a horse. As the race progresses, things get weirder. For instance, one horse transforms into an elephant swinging its trunk and then into a giraffe. The players have to watch the race and hope that their creature wins. On the downside, everything is in Japanese and the game's servers are offline. So you have to wait until Japan World Cup 4. Even so, there are some DVDs of the gameplay available on Amazon, and some have English subtitles. Number 2. Hatoful Boyfriend. It shouldn't surprise you that this super weird game comes from Japan. It's a dating simulator where the player assumes the role of a young, handsome man accepted at the prestigious St. Pidgeot Nations Institute. It so happens that all his classmates are talented female birds. You'll roam the hallways and try to find love in between lessons. There's also a mystery to solve besides dating pigeons. If that is not weird, then please tell us what is. Number 1. Who's Your Daddy? Starting out, the title is an offensive slang. Is the game offensive? First off, it's a multiplayer game where one player is the daddy and primary caregiver while the other plays a role as the baby. The goal of the daddy is to keep the baby safe throughout the day, which only lasts a few minutes. the baby has to make this impossible by finding ways to die. To do this, the baby may fall from tables, stick forks in the electric sockets, eat broken glass, or jump into the bathtub and drown. The daddy can earn power-ups and cure a sick or injured baby by feeding him fruits and pills. Don't expect the graphics to impress, despite it being a 2015 game. There is no single-player mode, and not everyone will enjoy the absurdity. So finding someone who enjoys the game might be a little challenging. That's all, folks. If you thought these games were weird, give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on Peachy Planet.